Dit zien. This institute I worked for 30 years at the, as curator of the Dubois collection, and Dubois is the founder of paleontology as a science. This museum, we are here, and I worked here for 30 years as curator of the paleontological mineralogical cabinet, the same position Dubois had from 1896 till 1940. So I'd like to tell about Dubois, what he did for paleontology. I'd like to tell a little what he did here, and I'd like to tell you in the tradition of Dubois, an hypothesis of which you think it's a nice idea, but he is crazy. If you accept it today, then the hypothesis is wrong. I expect that hypothesis will be accepted one generation after me, which is normal in paleoanthropology. Dubois? Yeah. Was born in 1858, 2 years after the Neanderthal man was found, and 1 year before Darwin published his famous book On the Origin of Species. Dubois was raised in a time when there was a discussion about evolution. For the animals it was okay, but for men it was not okay. And Dubois had the idea, I'd like to find hard evidence, real fossils, about the transitional form. Crazy idea about in those days. And he tried to arrange money, but he didn't succeed, and then he signed as a medical officer in the Dutch army, and went to the Indies. Here is a large picture. He is here. This is his wife. So he went for 7 years to the East Indies. With all the nuns. If the nuns had known that they have the devil with them, then they'd throw them overboard. But we were stationed in Sumatra, in the Padang Highlands, and he started immediately to search for the fossils. He found a lot of fossils, but they were too young to have a transitional form. When he was in Sumatra, he got a skull, which was fossilized, but this skull was coming from Java. It was fossilized, but you could immediately see that it was from a modern man. But attracted to this skull, he went from Sumatra to Java. And he started in caves. The idea was that the transitional man was found in caves, so he started in caves, and all the material was too young to have a transitional form. And then he did something what nobody before him had done. He was searching in river sediments and along the river of the Solo. And in there he found in sediments fossils which were very old and stegodon and things like that. And he could expect that if he liked to find something, he had to search there. And one of the sites here in Trinil, he found all old fossils. He started in May 1891, and here is his plan. This picture you have to remember, because I came back with another picture. This is a picture from 1891 in Trinil. And Jose will tell much more, Jose Jordans, who's sitting there, will tell much more about Trinil, about our planet size. So I don't go in detail to this, but here he found, what did he find? A molar, and he thought it was a molar of a chimpanzee. And the chimpanzee was called Anthropopithecus. And he found a skull of a brain size between man and the great apes, about 1000 CC. But he still thought, I have a chimpanzee, an Anthropopithecus. Anthropos is man, Pithecus is ape. Then, 1 year later, he found this. A femur, which was straight, which was more or less similar to the modern man. And you could see easily that the man, of the creature who possessed this, was walking upright. But in the beginning, he still thought, I have an ape, an Anthropopithecus, and because it was walking upright, he called it Anthropopithecus rectus. But then, it was 1892, and he was thinking, I have something with a small brain, which is walking upright, and on a rainy day, and it's always rainy here, he thought, Anthropopithecus, I changed it in Pithecanthropus. Pithecus is ape, Anthropos is man. You can see here science, yes? Pitting up, we now have all the computers, we will never find such things. But he changed it, and he said, I have my transition form. He was happy, and published it. But what is important, that he included postcranials to make his transition form. And after a lot of things were found. So he had an idea. It's an organism. And after him, all kinds of skulls and bits of skulls were found, and what they are doing now is making a model by putting the skulls on brain size, and that they call a model. But it is not a model. But now they have troubles with explaining the Flores man, which has a brain of 400 cc. So you have to make another model to explain the Homo floresiens. But it's easier explained by accepting that it's an island form. Yesterday we heard about pygmy elephants and pygmy hippopotamus. And that model also is the Homo floresiensis. He was happy, he published it. A stupid idea. Dubois, what do you have? You have only a molar, you have only a femur, and you have only a skull. And then you say it's transitional form. In 1894, religion was very strong. For animals, it was okay, but not for men. So it was... He made a reconstruction. It's the first reconstruction made of a transitional form. You see, it's... has long arms, it's short thumb, and he has a toe, which is a bone. And they excavated in Trinil with the help of Killer and the Winter. This is the site he excavated, and this is the site in 1900. This is huge excavated. Here, from the other side, he collected a lot of fossils here, and all those fossils you can find back in Natuanus. And you can do something with those things still. And in 1940 he died, and on his grave you see the skull and two fingers. The sculptor didn't know what to do with one bone. He made a pirate symbol out of it. In and Dubois was not happy with it because everybody was saying, what do you have? You have nothing. It took one generation before it was accepted. This morning I saw Marsh, a Marsh or a dino hunter, and because he didn't find, Dubois didn't find the skeletons of the things in articulation, and then they were asking, how do you know that they belong together? Marsh, a dino hunter, was used but never found a skeleton exactly when it is in articulation. So, nobody took one generation before it was accepted. The body came to the Netherlands, and in 1896 he became here curator of the Palaeontological Mineralogical Cabinet. He didn't like the academic world because everybody was behind his back saying that he was a stupid professor. He liked to be, he was living in Haarlem, and he liked to be here in Haarlem. And here in Haarlem was living Hugo de Vries. Lorenz was one of the curators, and Lorenz was friend of Einstein. So I'm now standing on the place of Einstein. Sorry. I'm not Einstein, but here Einstein was standing. He was here, but I always like to have the fossils with him, and the directors of the Teylers Museum gave him a safe, and he could put the fossils in the safe. And the safe was here in Teylers Museum. But in the 30s of him, after his death, the safe went to Natuanus with the other collection. Here is Dubois. And in the Netherlands, he started to collect a collection of Tegelen, whatever Tegelen may be, it's nothing. But he also made a collection of cars, of all the fossils which were excavated during till 1940. And you can find the cars back in the hall of fossils. But he also made a collection of Tegelen, whatever that may be. That was old, that was an old material, and he hoped, it was from Koningswald who said that Dubois hoped to find also a transitional form in that material. The collection which he made from Tegelen, you can find here also in the hall. Tegelen, here. Tegelen was a quarry, and the quarryman collected all the specimens and gave it to assistance of Dubois, and Dubois brought it here. He brought things to Amsterdam, the Zoological Museum, and a few things are in Maastricht. This is a reconstruction of Tegelen, and this is open wood. We, as a Dutch, we don't have quarries. We fish for fossils, and we fish in the eastern spell, and there are deep pits, and in those pits we find fossils, but also we suck sand, and all those people are collecting fossils there. But the material from the East Spout and from Mill and from the sack of Little are more or less the same. I don't know what's happening in the States, but something going on. They changed it. But this is the material you can find. There's no book here. The things are missing here. They're from Little and the other sides. No, I don't know what you're talking about. Doesn't matter. And if we look at the age, and it's about Tegelen, it's about 1.8, 1.9, because the absolute dates, you have to consider relatively. Yes, it's not absolute, those dates. But here we have the things we find in those Tegelen and those Oosterschelde and Wiesel and so on. And now we go to the Balizi, and David will tell everything about the Balizi. But if I look here, there's a site, and David knows more than a straight site. But he found all kinds of things which are more or less the same as you find here in the Oosterschelde, Tegelen, and so on. That is the same. And I know the Polynesian is foreign, and I know that every site has its own species and its own age. I hate local paleontology. I'm thinking about ecosystems. And the ecosystem of the open lookend was from England till, I think, Haarlem. That was just a bit of this is okay, now you have to accept for me that I hope you can accept them. That the fauna elements which I found here are the same as in Indonesia. Yes, and I don't discuss that there is that the homotherium is different. That's a matter of taxonomy, or that another species is different. No, it's the same. It's the same fauna. And if I look at the artifacts, these are the artifacts from the Manisi. And this is found in Wiesel. Okay, they are not in context, but I don't care. Here, this is the Manisi, and here we have Wiesel. And last year, we had some bones with probably, possibly, maybe, good bones. And the good bones are long bones. As the phone is the same as in the the artifacts, I would say, as in there's a bones with marks. Then Homo erectus was here in Europe about 1.8 million, whatever, ago. And Dubois also arrived straight away. It will take one generation before this will be accepted. But I'm convinced that Homo erectus, which is found in Indonesia, but also in Java, and we have only one skull from the Indian subcontinent, and one artifact in Pakistan, Malacca, that Homo erectus, which has a large variation in size, is only going to the east, as the environment is the same. In the same way, he went to the west and was here in Europe. Thank you.